Asher, look, it's Ireland, lads. We all knew this wasn't going to be easy. I'm going to react to the group draw.
It's just not good.
All right.
Are you looking for coins for Foot 21?
Hi, how are you?
Well, I got just the place for you. Visit igvault.com, the cheapest place to get your Foot 21 coins on the whole internet, man. And if you want a cheeky 6% off your order, then you use the code Brooksy at checkout. Link is in the description. Oh, yeah.
How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Brooksy HD, and today we have found out that is not English. I am Irish, after all. I should be speaking Oscuelaga. You have found out our group for the Qatar 2022 World Cup qualifying. We're in Group A. Now let's get on and show you who we have. So, on the SkySports.com website, we have the World Cup qualification draw in full. As you can see, we are in Group A. We've got Portugal. Portugal. Just, sorry. If you didn't hear me, yo, people in the back, yep. Ears up, lads. We got Portugal. It's not like Ronaldo's trying to, you know, score as many goals as he can to become the most international goal scorer of all time or anything like that. Bruno Fernandes plays for them. They got a really, really decent team. No? We're winning the group, boys. We're winning the group. We also have Serbia in the group. Now, this is where I'm not too sure. Serbia are renowned, in at least in my opinion, for being a very, very good national team. They always have really, really good players. Just a decent team. But I have a feeling that a lot of their team is coming towards the end of their international careers. Players like Matic, Milivojevic, Dusan Tadic, all those kind of players. But I do know they have some really, really good, high-quality players. Like Filip Kostic, for example. I rate him massively. I think he's a really, really good player. So, based off the first two teams we've been drawn in, I don't think we're winning the group. I don't think we're even getting second. Let's have a look. Luxembourg and Azerbaijan as our other two teams. We had a draw on this before Stephen Kenny took over. I would have said, yeah, guaranteed third. Now I don't know. Listen, I'm a Stephen Kenny advocate. I want Stephen Kenny to be our manager for a while. Bleed in all the youngsters that he can and get us playing really, really, really good football. We should beat them and we should beat Azerbaijan. No question about it. But it's giving me Cyprus 2005, 2006 vibes. If you remember that, I think we lost to Cyprus 5-2. Out of nowhere. It's giving me that kind of vibes. And I don't like it, boys. I'm not going to lie to you. Have a look quickly at the other groups. Groups we don't really care about. Don't really care about Group B. Care about Group C because big up my Northern Ireland brothers, you know. You've got a very tough group there. Group B is Belgium, Wales. Oh my God. Czech Republic, Belarus, and Estonia. Scotland have Denmark, Austria, Israel, Faroe Islands, and Moldova. They should do fairly well in that group. England have Poland, Hungary, Albania, Andorra, and San Marino. They should get top of this group, but Poland will give them a run for their money. Hungary are not, you know, the Hungary of 8 years ago, obviously, because they're all probably long gone in the ground. All right, so this is the last squad that was picked by Portugal. You can see all the players on the left here. Their goalkeeper situation is fine. They don't have any issues with goalkeeper. They got Rui Patricio. And if he doesn't start, then it's going to be Anthony Lopez. Two decent goalkeepers, in my opinion. Their defense, I would say, is probably their weakest area. But then again, they've still got Guerrero, who sometimes plays left back, but sometimes he also plays left mid. Sometimes he can even play center mid. But when your center backs are Jose Fonte, Ruben Semedo, Ruben Diaz, we haven't seen anything from Diaz yet at City. We have, I think Ruben Semedo is literally a criminal. And also Jose Fonte is 36 years old. So they could be beaten with their defense. It's just their attack. Cristiano Ronaldo, even players like Diego Jota, Joao Felix. How in the name of God is Shane Duffy, Dara O'Shea, John Egan, Matt Doherty, Enda Stevens, how are they going to stop players like this? It's just not going to happen. I would love it to, but it's just not going to happen. In their midfield, man, Jao Moutinho is a classy player. Bernardo Silva, Bruno, like, it's just oozes quality. Ruben Neves, it's just a quality team. All round, it's just a fantastic team. Their defense is a little bit shaky, 100%. It can be got at. But when you look at Ireland's players, can they get it anyway? You had Aaron Connolly, who looks like our best player at the moment when he plays for Ireland. And then you got players like Callum Robinson. You got, you know, Shane Long. All these sort of boys, Adam Eder. They're not that good at the moment. I don't think we're going to score against Portugal in either of the games. This is Serbia's last team that they called up for the game against Russia in the Nations League. Their goalkeeper has always been a sore spot. They always used the same goalkeeper that was like 38 or whatever. But recently, Rajkovic, He's playing for Reims in France. He's been pretty decent in that league. So he's obviously the starting goalkeeper now. So not a bad goalkeeper by any means. Their defense, at least according to this anyways, is a little bit suspect. We also have some players down here like Kolarov, for example. Velkovic, I know he plays, yeah, Werder Bremen. Maximovic, Napoli. Like, they're not as good as Portugal defensively at all. And even the Portugal's defense is a little bit weak. It's definitely their weakest position. So maybe their defense is an area to get at. But we've played Serbia before. And we've done pretty well against them. But I can vividly remember Alexander Kolarov scoring against us. So that was fun. And this was the game. Oh, God, that was horrible. Actually, this specific team here is actually missing a lot of players. We're going to look into it in like a minute. Nemanja Gedel plays for Sevilla. Really, really, like, good holding midfielder, playmaker kind of, like, addition. They have a decent team. It's not amazing at the moment, but then you look at the midfielders that they could potentially bring in. Marko Grujic playing for Porto. Kostic playing for Eintracht Frankfurt. Even players like Matic, they might be past it at club level. But internationally, I haven't obviously watched Serbia play much football, apart from the games they were playing against us and like a couple of highlights and stuff like that. You look at their like attackers, they got Luka Jovic, lethal finisher. I know he's been injured a lot and he's not really done much for Real Madrid, but it's kind of hard to see past that, how much of a good finisher he is. He's a clinical finisher on his day. I don't know much about Vlahovic. Alexander Mitrovic, 36 goals in 61 games. We are going to struggle against Portugal and Serbia. I mean, they don't even say Dusan Tadic. Oh, no, they do, yeah. Milinkovic-Savic! Milinkovic... We're doomed. We're doomed. And then just quickly, we'll look at the Luxembourg team and the Azerbaijan team. I don't really know many of the Luxembourg team. I know Thill, wherever Thill is. Yeah, I think there's a few Thills. Yeah, there is, yeah. Sebastian Thill, Vincent Thill. I also know Gerson Rodriguez from Dynamo Kiev, sorry. And also, there was a guy that plays for Mainz. They don't have a great team, and we should be beating them. Will we? Like, we're going to find out, because I don't know. And then the Azerbaijan team, as you can see on the right-hand side here, the entirety of their last teams for playing Slovenia, Montenegro, and Luxembourg, they all play in Azerbaijan. There is a couple of players that don't play in there. Like, there's a guy who plays in Spain and Greece and Turkey and in Switzerland. I actually know who Dadashov is. He used to play for Leipzig, I think, and then he plays for Wolves. He's on loan at Grasshopper. I don't think we should have any trouble against, you know, a team like Azerbaijan, but then again, you should really be saying that about, you know, Bulgaria, for example. We should have bet Bulgaria both times we played them, but we didn't, because we're useless at the moment. And then lastly, we're going to look at when all the games are going to be taking place. As you can see, our first set of games will be on the March 24th to the 25th in 2021. So hopefully, you know, the virus will be gone by then. We can all go and see these games at the Aviva or wherever they are. If it's in Serbia, if it's in, I wouldn't go to Serbia actually, but I would go to Portugal. It's a nice place. I can't see us getting anything other than third. I think literally the way that the group was drawn out, Portugal, Serbia, Ireland, Luxembourg and Azerbaijan, I think that's how the group is going to end. I really don't want it to. I would love to get second. I don't know what the situation is with the playoffs, whether the playoffs even are said anything about here. Okay, so for the three places, Jesus Christ, we'll be fought out between the 10 group. We have to get first. We have to get first to qualify because we did useless in the Nations League. Oh, no. We're not going to Qatar, boys. We're not going to Qatar. We can celebrate that Christmas at home. Anyways, boys, this is just a completely random video. I just wanted to give my opinion on this. Thank you very much for watching this video. Links to my Twitter, my Instagram, my Twitch page, which I'll be streaming on later on today if you want to come over and watch me, all in the description. Make sure you drop a like. Tell me what you think the group's going to be. So, yeah, where do you think Ireland's going to finish in the group? I genuinely think third is where we're finishing. And, yeah, I'll see you in the next video, boys. Have a wonderful day. Bye.